there anything a Tesla can't do? Elon Musk presently says the Tesla show ass drifts all around okay to transform it into a pontoon for brief time frames. That makes it one of a modest bunch of autos fixed all around okay to remain above water for in excess of a small amount of a moment before capitulating to approaching water. Try not to trust it? Tesla's CEO additionally posted a connection of a Tesla Model S in Moscow crashing into an overflowed underpass, riding on the water, evidently advancing and to the opposite side of the flooding under its own particular power, at that point driving by means of the wheels as the underpass slanted upward, recapturing footing on the asphalt and proceeding as an auto. As indicated by Musk, push is by means of wheel turn. Before you attempt this all alone, Tesla. There's a distinction between an auto that buoys, for some time, an auto, for example, Tesla that has some capacity to move itself along in the water, and a watercraft that blossoms with water. On the off chance that you truly need to recreate the Moscow trap, twofold check with Tesla. In the event that water gets into any opening, for example any of the auto's lighting modules, erosion is somewhere close to likely an assurance. It's surprisingly more terrible if it's saltwater. The general design of flooding is that if an auto is overflowed to the level of the sections of flooring, your insurance agency pronounces it an aggregate misfortune and needs the auto pulverized quickly so garbage yard foragers don't endeavor to dry out segments and exchange them, knowing they'll bomb soon. Incidentally, if your auto goes in the water, get the windows open immediately, before the electrical energy to the window winder shorts out. When the auto is submerged, it might be too difficult to open the entryways. What's more, kicking out a window is a considerable measure harder than it looks. Not the primary, not the last maritime vehicle. The land and or water capable auto doesn't have an incredible rep of the flying auto. All things considered, the embellishments craftsmen at James Bond Incorporated transformed a Lotus into a submarine in The Spy Who Loved Me in 1977. The embellishments wheels withdrew into the bodywork, supplanted by an arrangement of jumping planes, and different propellers moved it along. This one likewise had a rocket